Before you can start watching Cardassy tutorials and learn flourishing online, you have to know the name of the most basic grips to hold the deck of cards. In general, your non-dominant hand, if you are right-handed, that will be your left hand, and vice versa, will be your resting hand and will most of the time grip the deck from underneath. And your dominant hand, in my case the right hand, will most of the time grip it from the top. Now to the grips. We start with the dealer's grip, also called the mechanic's grip. This is the most basic grip and you should get used to it because you'll use it all the time and it's used as the base for most cuts. And you get into it by placing your thumb onto the left side of the deck, your middle finger, ring finger, and pinky finger on the right side of the deck, and your index finger is on the top side of the deck. And that's just the basic dealer's grip. There's also a variation of it called the elevated dealer's grip, where you just elevate it with your thumb and hold it like so away from your palm. And this is used for a few cuts where you should start out with the elevated position. Now for the next grip would be the straddle grip. And this grip provides more stability than the dealer's grip. And it takes a while to get used to it, but it is used in a lot of cuts, so you should get used to it. And basically the only thing that happens is your pinky finger moves from the side to the bottom to straddle the deck between your index and pinky finger. And this provides more stability than the dealer's grip. And there's also a variation called the elevated straddle grip, where you elevate your hand, elevate the deck into your hand, same as in the elevated dealer's grip, and you just hold it away from your palm. And this is used in a lot of cuts where it just looks better if the deck is elevated in your hand and not just in your palm. And there are also other variations with the straddle grip, for example the Sybil straddle grip, where the packet is straddled between your middle pinky and ring finger, or also this version. It's just straddled in different ways, also in the one-handed fan. It's also a straddle grip between your index and pinky finger. So you should get used to straddling the deck, which can be quite new to your fingers because you apply pressure to the inside of the fingers. Now for the next grip, this is the biddle grip. You place your thumb onto the short side of the edge and your ring finger and middle finger onto the other short side of the deck, and your index finger is normally curled on top. There are also a lot of variations to this one where just your middle finger and thumb hold it with your index curled in, or the whole hand and the thumb is more in the middle. Basically, this one would be the most basic version because it allows to do a swing cut with the curled in index finger, which breaks off the packet or splits the packet. But you can basically also hold it with your index finger, and it's just basic grip for your right hand. And this is also used in a lot of cuts. The next grip would be the corner grip. This only applies to small parts of the deck because you can't hold the whole deck in corner grip. Well, you basically can, but you can't do anything with it. But basically, you take it between your middle finger and your thumb. This part of your thumb and this part of your middle finger will kind of straddle the packet between your fingers, and your index finger is curled on top. So it's basically a modified biddle grip. But the thing is, you can now rotate the packet with your index finger or also other fingers. and this is used in a lot of flourishes. And there are also a lot of versions of it with almost everything, every finger, where you can do different things with it. And also in your left hand, and even parts of your hand in, for example, the tornado cut, which is also used a lot. The next thing is the Cardini grip, which also applies to only a certain part of the packet and not the whole. Basically, you grip the deck between your middle finger on top, your pinky on top, and your ring finger is curled underneath the pack, like so. So you basically place these fingers on top, all the way back, also this finger, and your ring finger should be with this part on the deck. And this allows you to extend and grip the packet stable in your hand, which also results in the Cardini cut. And this has also a lot of variations with, for example, the right hand, but it's basically always the same: ring finger, pinky finger, middle finger, and this part of your ring finger just push against each other and you can extend it. Now for the basic two-handed grips, this would be, for one, the C grip, which looks like this, which is a C, therefore the name. And to get into it, you will use the mechanics grip and the biddle grip, and take the deck, split the deck with the biddle grip, just take a packet off the deck, like so. Middle finger, index on top, or index curled, however you want. Thumb on this side, on the whole side. And now, after you splitted the deck, your thumb will push against your index finger and break off another packet, like so. And this is the C grip, which is used in a lot of flourishes. So again, biddle grip on this side, mechanics in this hand, split by pulling back with those fingers against your thumb, just on the side, and then push with your thumb against your index finger to break off another packet and lift it up, like so. And contrary to the C grip, there's also a reverse C grip, where you kind of reverse the things and get a reverse C, because in this version you will place your thumb on this side and your index on this side, so it's kind of a modified elevated straddle grip. So from here, from your straddle grip, elevated, place your thumb on this side, pinky on this side. So you now hold the deck like this, come over again in the biddle grip, and break off a packet, but not like this, as you would in a normal C grip, but you break it off reversed. So you break off with the thumb, but not with the middle finger and ring finger, and you lift up another packet with the middle finger and ring finger on this side, like so. So the packet is now reversed between your middle finger and thumb, instead of your thumb and index finger in a normal C grip. This is also used in a few flourishes like Eco. And then there's the Sybil grip, which is a modified version of the Z grip, but the only thing that's different is you split the packet held by your right hand a second time to get this shape which is called the civil grip. So again, come over, hold it with your dealer's grip, come over in middle grip, split at your thumb, middle finger and ring finger, lift it up on this side against your index finger, and now your free index finger will split this packet again against your thumb, and your middle finger and ring finger are now holding this packet, and your index finger will hold this packet. So basically from the C grip, another split, and you're in the civil grip. And this should happen everything at the same time to do the civil cut, which is also a very basic cut. And then there are also a few other more exotic grips, which would be, for example, the Erdnase grip, where you kind of hold the deck in this weird position with your thumb this side and your pinky on this side to straddle the deck, and those three fingers are now free and can do all sorts of things with the deck. It's used in a three flourishes, I think. And also the molecule grip, which is basically a modified dealer's grip, where your middle finger comes from the side onto the top, which looks like this, and this allows for the molecule cuts. But yeah, that's about everything about the grips.